Linksys E3000 router JTAG programming. This is a quite capable router, and JTAG programming is a little bit challenging. This is the board. To open the case, start from front and work the way back. This is JTAG port. Use 10-pin header to solder to the board. There are 5 missing 0-ohm resistors. Be very careful when bridging these pads, since they are extremely small. You need to cut a small portion of the JTAG connector to be able to press to the pin header. Back up. It is very important to back up your original flash. Whenever there is a need, you can always use this file to restore your router. Use power switch to power on the router and hit detect, and then type program to enter trap on mode. If you do not do this quickly, the router might reset itself while reading or writing because of the router watchdog. This video is uncut, so the time to do the programming on video is the exact time needed to program the router. Program openwrt. Erase the NVRAM. File from openwrt has a 32 bytes header that needs to be removed. Here is a look of openwrt running on Linksys E3000. Program dd-wrt. Here is a look of dd-wrt running on Linksys E3000. Debrick. Normally you can use programming kernel and an NVRAM to debrick the router. Only use this method when your CFE is erased or corrupted and you cannot reliably enter trap on mode. Only use slow programming to program the CFE, and once CFE is programmed, then you can power off and on the router and enter trap on and do fast programming.